Yes. So once again, good afternoon, students. So now I can see for previous classes we have seen the definition of Laplace transform. You can see here, let f of b be a function of t defined for all positive values of t. Then the Laplace transform of f of t denoted by L of f of t and is defined by L of f of t is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f t dt, provided the integral exists. That is what it says from the Laplace transform definition. Okay, we have already seen this. Then here we have to note a very simple notes we have, where s is some parameter or complex value. Next we have L of f of t is equal to, we also call this as f dash of s, or which is equal to capital S, capital F of s. It can be written as in this form also, f of t is equal to L inverse capital F of s is equal to L inverse f dash of s. Okay, then we say f of t is equal to L inverse f dash of s is equal to L inverse capital F of s is called inverse Laplace transform of capital F of s. S runs, very simple it is. So next, I think this we have seen that very important.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sorry to interrupt. Sir, my friend Mahesh Kalagi is not able to enter the class.
Okay, just wait. Why? I think everybody has joined. Okay, so I think now he has joined. Okay, fine. So it will take time. So one by one, it will take 2 to 3 minutes. Don't worry. So okay, so we'll continue. Laplace transform of some standard functions or elementary we have taken. That is already we have seen Laplace of 1 is equal to 1 upon s. So how this is proved, that L of 1 is equal to 1 upon s, by using this definition. Easily one can solve, simplify this. L of 1 is equal to 1 upon s you can get. And next formula, that is L of t raised to n is equal to n factorial s raised to n plus 1. So very important formula. Don't reduce this formula at least. So my good students, what they do, they want to reduce this formulas also. वो क्या सोचते हैं कि इसमें से भी reduce कर सकते हैं क्या? But no, this is quite very important. The next formula, that is Laplace e raised to a t is equal to 1 upon s minus a. Next formula, L of s sine a t is equal to a upon s square plus a square. Please remember, s is a parameter greater than 0. Okay, so some parameter it is. Next formula, we have L of cos a t is equal to s of s square plus a square. And then L of sine hyperbolic sine a t is equal to a upon s square minus a square. Then we have Laplace transform of cos hyperbolic cos a t is equal to s upon s square minus a square, friends. Okay, so this is what I have just repeated and revised formula once again. Okay, so for today's we see the very important and definite question for the final exam. Please remember this, friends. For the internal, definitely you are going to get the very important property by using, that is we say the shifting property, as we have seen. I think I have already posted in the Google class also, right? So here we can see easily these are the properties. In this property we can see we are using this frequency shift, that is e raised to a t f of t, which is capital F s minus a. So this fourth property I'm going to use, that is property L of e raised to a t f of t is equal to capital F s minus a. So very important property, students. So please note down this property. So by using this property, you can see here very easily, one can easily see that it says if any function is given, f of t may be any sine, cos, tan, right? Let it be t or any value they have given, just multiplied e raised to a t. So what happens to this? Any Laplace transform formula, just you are going to add this minus a. So please remember, so how you are going to add one by one, I will show you. So this property says, suppose, so Laplace transform of e raised to at, right? So you have seen this is equal to 1 upon s minus a. This is the normal Laplace transform without using the property. Am I right? So now we can see Laplace transform, when I multiply e raised to 18 into t raised to n. Okay, already you know the formula of t raised to n. So please remember the formula for t raised to n. It is n factorial upon s raised to n plus 1. But see that in simple, I will show you. Wherever this transformation takes place, only you have to change s as s minus a. Please keep this in your mind. So this is what you are going to change. So all the formulas immediately you can easily change. So whenever e raised to at is multiplied to any function, sine, cos, t, right? For this, you are going to change only s to s minus a. So please keep this in your mind, students. Very, very important. This is for shifting property. Okay. So now you can see. So this is actually Laplace transform of e raised to at into t raised to n, which is equal to n factorial upon s minus a raised to n plus 1. Okay. So what I have done here, just you can see this previous slide, that in this Laplace transform, what I have done, yes. Okay, this was the formula, that is Laplace transform of t raised to n was the formula. Only here you are going to change s as s minus a. So everywhere, wherever there is s is there, you are going to change only s minus a. So please remember this one. So similarly, you can see here, that is sine at is equal to Laplace transform of sine at is equal to a upon s square plus a square is there. But when you multiply e raised to at, this will become s minus a the whole square plus a square. So everywhere, please remember this now. In the shifting property, you can see here, whenever I multiply e raised to at, sine bt is equal to will become b upon s minus a square plus b square. Okay. Similarly, Laplace transform of e raised to at into cos bt will become s minus a divided by s minus a the whole square plus b square. Okay. Similarly, we have Laplace transform of e raised to at sine h, that is hyperbolic sine bt, is equal to b upon s minus a the whole square minus b square. So Laplace transform of e raised to at into hyperbolic cos bt is equal to s minus a divided by s minus a the whole square minus b square. Is it clear? So all formulas I have listed over here, multiplying e raised to at. See, everything will change now. Multiplication, we don't have direct formula, but see that we can use this property and we get this all six very important formulas. Is it clear? Now in exam, what will they were going to put? So you can just take the first column. So this I will take first one as putting a is equal to 2. Suppose there is b is there, b is equal to, I will take this as some 3. Yes, beta.
I'm just trying to join, sir. Ankit Patil.
So where is he? Admitted. Okay. So it is he is also admitted. I think Ankit is admitted, I think. Yes.
No, sir.
So this is property number 2.
Admit all. Yes. So this is property. You can see here in this, it is fourth property. I think all of them have joined. So now you can see this is fourth property already posted in your class. Okay. You can see this is your class. So it is already posted. Okay, fine. So now you can see put a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3. So all this, suppose in the exam they may put a is equal to 3, b is equal to 3, but how you are going to write? So this will become Laplace transform of e raised to 2t, they may ask, but see, you can write it very easily, 1 divided by s minus 2 is the answer. Is it clear? Have you understood what I said? I said that I'm going to put a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 3. Okay, so what will happen? All this will be changed like this. So Laplace transform of e raised to 2t, t raised to n remains as it is, please remember this. So n factorial upon s minus 2 raised to n plus 1. Okay, similarly this formula you can see, Laplace transform of e raised to 2t, and this is sine 3t. So easily you can, anyone can write it very easily in one step, that is 3 divided by s minus 2 square plus 3 square. This is the answer. Okay, so suppose Laplace transform of e raised to 2t, this is cos 3t. If they ask, so use this property, it will become s minus 2 divided by s minus 2 square plus 3 square. Okay,
so this is the additional formula.
Nay, this is just, you have to remember, they may ask any value. No, yes, these 6 are additional formulas. By using these 6 formulas, I am substituting a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3. So directly you can easily write it. So this is e raised to,
okay sir,
e raised to 2t. Okay, and this is hyperbolic sine 3t. If they ask in the exam, so directly you can put this property formula and you can write here b is equal to 3. So this is 3 divided by s minus 2 square minus 3 square. So you can save your time using this formulas. So this is Laplace transform of e raised to 2t. This is hyperbolic cos bt is equal to b is now 3. Okay, so s minus 2 divided by s minus 2 square minus 3 square. So what I have done, let them ask any value, just substitute a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 3, you will get the answer. So you can take the next as the homework. Okay, you can take, put a is equal to 4 and b is equal to 6, you can take. Okay, and write down all this 6 formulas directly. A is equal to 4, b is equal to 6. So means what I wanted to say you is, suppose they ask,
post it in the classroom, sir.
In the form, yes, beta.
Sir, excuse me, sir, screen is not visible.
Screen is not visible. I think all of them have joined. Yes, all 34 have joined.
Sir, yes, sir, it is working now. Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you. So what I was saying is, if you take this Laplace transform, suppose if they ask Laplace transform of e raised to 2t sine 3t, by using this, easily one can write all these values. Suppose they ask Laplace transform of e raised to 4t, and this is sine 6t. If they ask in the exam, directly by using this formula, one can easily write this is 6 divided by s minus 4 square plus 6 square. So like this one I have shown you. So all these 6 you can solve this very easily. Is it clear? Okay, so now we have next problems on finding the Laplace transform of the following. So such examples will come in the exam. So now you can see f of t is equal to e raised to 2t sine 3t. What is the answer? Yes, such examples will come in the exam, but don't get afraid that it is multiplication is there. So you can see this a you can see Laplace transform of f of t. They have given here, this is equal to Laplace transform of e raised to 2t sine 3t. Suppose if they have given like this, then this will be equal to, already you have solved this. This is Laplace transform e raised to 2t sine 3t is equal to, directly one can use this formula and get the answer, that is 3 divided by s minus 2 square plus 3 square. This is the answer, students. Is it clear? Yes, have you understood first example?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So means what? I have substituted here a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 3 in this formula, which is that this formula, that is third formula. I can see here a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 3. I have substituted. Easily one can get the answer directly. Yes or no? So this property is very easy and it helps to get the answer directly. Okay, next we'll go with the b1. Yes, now you can see this is f of t. Yes, beta.
So, but where it is mentioned to put 8, 2 and 3?
Hey, it is not mentioned, beta. See what I said. Okay, see. Suppose they ask in the exam this question, that is e raised to 2t, t raised to n. So, immediately you can see a is equal to 2 is there. So, n factorial upon s minus 2 the whole raised to n plus 1. Suppose they ask in the exam Laplace transform e raised to 2t sine 3t, one can easily get, substituting the value a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3. Then you can see 3 divided by s minus 2 the whole square plus 3 square. Is it clear? In the exam, they will ask only LHS part. RHS part, you can just substitute the values whatever they ask. Whatever they let them ask, any value, no. So, first example you have seen. Here you can see, immediately compare this question with AT and sine BT. You have to compare this. Immediately by comparing these two equations, easily you can understand A is 2 and B is 3. Suppose in the exam if they ask E raised to 5T and sine 6T, right? Easily one can compare the equation and you can see A is equal to 5, B is equal to 6, right? So by using A and B, let A and B be any value. Directly use this third formula, e raised to at sine bt, change a and b. That is what my intention to tell you, that let them give any value, a and b. Only a and b will change everywhere in this six formulas. Just substitute that directly value, you will get the RHS. Is it clear?
Yes, yes sir.
Any doubt? Okay. So a and b you have to identify. Is it clear? This A and B, you have to identify. Is it clear? Okay. So next we'll continue. So f of t is equal to e raised to t sine 3t. That is sine cube t they have given. Okay. So how you can solve? First you should know the formula. I think I have uploaded the formula. But let us see, let us see once. This is a formula list. I think everyone got this formula list. I told
yes, sir.
Of the friends that go through this formula. Okay, so we'll just see. It is page number 10. So when you go to page number 10, I think you must get that formula. Yes. So this all formulas everyone must know, right? Okay, then this formula list you can see directly. What is sine cube a? So a is the value. Can you see the screen, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes,
so you
sir.
Can see here sine cube a is given, but here we are using t. So directly by using this formula list, it is 3 sine t minus sine 3 t divided by 4. Directly you can use this formula here. So we know that. So this is sine 3. Okay. I will take sine cube t is equal to, this is 3 sine t minus sine 3t divided by 4. So from where I have taken this runs, I have taken from this formula list. So please everyone go through once and write down the formulas, practice this trigonometric formulas, right? So I think in the previous class I told you go through this formula, okay, but I have given everything available in your hand. Is it clear? So my, what I say, all the information I'm giving in your hand, and only thing you have to do, practice, right? Okay, so this is our now. So I think you remember that f of t, I cannot solve this directly. Yes, because I don't have any formula for Laplace transformation for sine cube t. So what I do, I'll just simplify this function in this fashion. So now you can see here, I can very easily modify this equation, I say. So this is equal to e raised to t. I will substitute the value. This is 3 sine t minus sine 3t divided by, it is 4. And is it clear? So what I have done, I have just substituted this value by using this formula. Okay, now further I will modify this such a way that it must be in the form of this e raised to at sine bt form, so that I can use this formula directly. So one can easily understand this. This is equal to 1 upon 4 is constant. I will remove it outside. So I'm just modifying this runs. Okay, so here you can see 3, I will take it outside. E raised to t, I will multiply inside sine t. Is it clear? Then this is again minus e raised to t sine 3t. So why I have modified like this one? Because I want e raised to t sine t and e raised to t sine 3t. So that I have one formula. Which is that formula? It is known as shifting property formula. That is e raised to at sine bt. Now easily one can see what is a and what is b. So okay, now I will apply. See, till you modify this question, don't apply Laplace transformation directly. Many of them students have seen in the semester exam, horrible, directly they apply the Laplace transform without thinking. But you concentrate and look at the question properly. See, now I can apply Laplace transform for f of t. Is it clear? So this will become 1 upon 4, I will take it outside. Okay, so 3 I will remove outside because it is constant. This is Laplace transform of e raised to t sine t minus Laplace transform of e raised to t sine 3t. Is it clear? I think this is clear now. Okay, so why I have made like this, friends? Because I want to make this in this form fashion, that is e raised to at sine bt. Now one can easily identify what is e raised to. Here I can see in this, okay, a is 1 and b is also 1. Is it understood? Is it clear how to identify a and b? Here you can see in this, you can easily make out a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 3. So now you can apply Laplace transformation. This will become 3. Now you can see this formula very easily. Please remember this formula, students. E raised to at sine bt is b upon s minus a the whole square plus b square. Otherwise, I will just take this formula so that it will be easy for you. Which formula I am using? Yes, this formula I am using. So now you can see a is 1, b is 1. So this is 1, divided by s minus 1 square plus 1 square. So how I have got this Laplace transform? By using this formula. Minus, next, again now here a is 1, b is 3. So therefore, this is 3 divided by s minus 1 square plus 3 square. Is it clear? This is actually the Laplace transform. So you will get Laplace transform in one step. Only thing you have to modify properly. Further, you can simplify this, otherwise not required, but you can just simplify this writing like this, 1 upon 4, I will keep it as it is. So I will just take 3 inside this bracket. This is going to become s minus 1 square. 1 square is 1, so I will keep it as it is. This is 3 divided by s minus 1 square, 9. This is our answer. Please remember, whenever in the exam you finish the answer, write your answer, and then if possible keep this in the bracket so that easily one can identify your answer. Yes, where is your answer? This is your answer. Is it clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I think you are understanding very easily. So will you try for the next one? That is C. F of t is equal to e raised to t sine 2t into sine t. So let us see the next. Okay, so this is what they have given here. This is t, it is not copied, don't worry. Okay, this is the c part, right? So now again you can see there is no multiplication property in the Laplace transform. So I cannot simplify this directly. So what I can do, I will go to the formula list once again. Yes, where is the formula? You can see here easily. Sine into sine, this is.
Give me, sir.
Yes, beta.
So formula list will be given in the exam.
What is this? You have to buy it, beta. So only I'm telling you to buy it, this formula. They will not okay, give sir. You. Okay. Good question. How formula list is given? I am also getting confused. So you have to remember this formula. So only I'm telling you, note down this formula, practice this formula. This is sine A into sine B is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B divided by 2. Is it clear? Otherwise, you can take this minus outside. So minus 1 upon 2 cos A plus B minus cos A minus B. That will be easy to remember. So please remember the formula, which form I'm going to, I will write it here once again, don't worry. That is sine A sine B is equal to minus 1 upon 2 cos A plus B minus cos A minus B. This formula you have to remember. Is it clear? Okay, next. So I will simplify this first. That is, so I have to modify this. Is it clear? So why I'm modifying? Because I don't have formula, Laplace transformation for this directly. So we can see here A, I have taken 2t, and B, you can compare this equation and this equation. B is only t. Okay, so you have to identify, they will not give you. So A I will substitute now, minus 1 upon 2 is as it is, you cannot change. Next, this is cos A plus B. A plus B means, you can see 2t plus t will become 3t. So A plus B will become 3t minus cos, yes, A minus B. A minus B means 2t minus t will become t. So this is t. So all the steps I am showing you, because you must not get confused that from where this step is coming. So again, I have not applying the Laplace, please remember. I have to still modify this. So minus 1 upon 2, I will bring it outside because I don't want this to disturb my formula. I will take e raised to at is e raised to t cos 3t minus e raised to t cos t. Is it clear? So now you can see this both. Is it familiar? Yes. So you can see which formula I'm going to use. Okay, this is the formula. Is it right? Is it right formula I'm choosing, students? So this formula I will choose. I will remember this in my mind and I will use this formula here. So this formula I'm going to use. Please remember this formula and practice this formula. In this, you can compare this equation and this equation. You can easily see. So now this is comparable. So now I can apply Laplace transform. So Laplace transform f of t will become minus 1 upon 2 as it is. Okay, so this is Laplace transform of e raised to t cos 3t minus Laplace transform of e raised to t cos t. So one can easily see and compare the equation directly. Now substitute by looking at this. A is equal to 1. You have to identify what is A and what is B? 3. Am I right? So if you look at this and compare with this equation, you can see A is 1 as well as B is also 1. Am I right? So now directly use the formula. So this is equal to minus 1 upon 2. I have taken outside. So now this is S minus 1. I have taken 1 because A is 1. Here you can see A is 1. Okay. So now divided by S minus 1 square plus 3 square. So why I have taken 3? B is 3. You can see here B, students. B is 3. Don't write B square again. It is 3 square because B I have taken 3. Now I will move to the next one. Minus. In this equation, you can see A is 1, B is 1. So therefore, Laplace transform will become S minus 1 divided by S minus 1 square plus 1 square because B is 1. You can see I am going to change only A and B, and therefore you can further simplify, or this is your answer. Okay, so further you can simplify very easily. 1 upon 2 I will write as it is, S minus 1 divided by S minus 1 square plus 3 square, you can write easily, 9 minus S minus 1 divided by S minus 1 square plus 1 square is 1. Okay. With my answer. Is it clear, students? Any doubt, please ask me. So you can simplify this very easily by only practice 2 to 3 times. For diploma students, I tell them at least 3 times you have to practice without seeing. Some of my good students, what they do, they will just copy down as it is. But when I post this notes in your Google class, see that you write down the question without seeing, you have to write in the fair book. Yes.
Okay, sir.
If you have any doubt, please ask your question. Any doubt, students? Everything is clear. Shall we move to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So now you can see very easily, one can easily solve Laplace transform by using this shifting property. Is it clear? Okay.
So in an exam, how many marks are Laplace transformation?
Yes, it is exactly divided into 4. Okay, students.